name is Dr. Esther Trufan, and in this video, I'm going to demonstrate how to recover the salt from our saltwater solution and how to recover the sand after we completed our filtration. So the first thing I'm going to need is the result of my filtration setup. Here I have the sand on the wet filter paper still inside the funnel, and here I have the salt dissolved in water. From here, we can start the extraction process. The filter paper, well, needs to be dried. So for that, we will need a source of heat, and for us, it will be a hot plate. To get it dry, we're going to place it on a watch glass on top of a hot plate. And this should be set to a medium-low temperature so that it does not burn the paper. So very gently, using your fingers, because this is just wet paper, you can extract it from the funnel and place it on the watch glass. Next, you can remove your funnel, set it aside, place it on the hot plate, and wait until all the water evaporates from it. The final piece is going to be weighing everything. So for that, we're going to need a scale, and because we are recovering two ingredients or two substances, we're going to need two weighing boats and two spatulas to go with them. You can use the same spatula, just make sure that you clean and dry the spatula between uses. It has been approximately 25 minutes since we started the evaporation of water in two different setups. First, we have the filter paper with the wet sand on a watch glass, and that was evaporating slowly. It is dry now, and we can tell because the paper unfolded itself and the sand is dry within, and you can see it's falling apart and it's sandy. Our water evaporated, and now we are left with some salt residue. Let's record the recovered masses for the salt and the sand. I will turn off my hot plate and set it aside, bring in my scale, turn it on, bring in a clean weighing boat, tear it, and then because paper doesn't get very hot, I can pick it up from here and transfer it onto the weighing boat. If we did a good job, then the sand should very easily let go of the paper and should find itself in the weighing boat. There are probably some very fine sand particles stuck to the paper, but we expect some loss. Still, our recovered mass for the sand is 5.06 grams. Next, we're going to do the same thing with the salt, except the salt is in this beaker and we'll need to scrape it out carefully. The first thing we do is take a clean weighing boat, place it on the scale, and tear it. Next, when the beaker is cold enough to work with, we're going to scrape out the salt from within. And we have to be somewhat gentle because the beaker is made of glass and it is relatively easy to break glass. The other thing that you may be mindful of is if it takes too long to scrape, then sometimes your scale may turn off in the meantime. So in those instances, it may be better to remove your weighing boat, turn on your scale, tear it, place the weighing boat on top, record the mass of your weighing boat, and then even if your scale turns off, you will know the mass of your weighing boat, and then from the combined mass of the weighing boat with the salt, you can always capture the mass of the salt. So the mass of my weighing boat is 2.31 grams. But I do have some more salt to work with. It is important to put in some solid effort, but when you get really tired and you can't remove any more salt from the beaker unless you break it, it's best to stop. So at that point, you record the combined mass of your weighing boat with the salt, and in this case, it is 6.57 grams. And you will say, this is as much as could be recovered using the methods and the techniques that you applied. The other way to extract the salt from the beaker, in case you don't need it back, is to use chemical means. You can always transfer your salt back into the beaker, put it on the scale, record your mass with the salt and the beaker combined. Then you wash and dry your beaker, you put it back on the scale, and you know exactly how much salt there was separated. But mind you, you did not recover that because you flushed it down the drain through washing it. So if you want to recover it, you need to scrape it and measure it out. If you just want to know how much was there, then you can always just rinse it out and identify how much mass of salt could have been recovered if you put in more effort.